Namaste. Mahabahu. That's what we saw last week, and we are going to continue with that again today. As we saw, Arjuna addresses Sri Krishna three times as Mahabahu. The last episode, we saw chapter 6, sloka 38. In this chapter, we are going to look at 11th chapter and 18th chapter. 11th chapter, 23rd sloka, 18th chapter, 1st sloka. In these two places, Arjuna addresses Sri Krishna as Mahabahu. 11th chapter, moment we say 11, I want all of you to think it is Vishwarupa. Whether you look at a watch at 11 a.m. or 11 p.m. or cricket at 11 people playing, whatever it is, 11 means Vishwarupa. So here, we are going to look at Sri Krishna's Vishwarupa in 11th chapter. True to his term as Mahabahu, in 11th chapter, Sri Krishna shows himself in his complete form and which no human eye can see it. He blesses Arjuna with a Divya Sakshas. Remember this. Only with a divine vision, anybody can see Krishna in his true form. And that is what 11th chapter is all about, where Sri Krishna shows himself in his true form and Arjuna's reaction on seeing or being blessed with Sri Krishna's Vishwarupa Darshan. So, here Arjuna is looking at Sri Krishna in his Vishwarupa, huge form. And we saw in Sarvaloka Maheshwara that there are seven worlds above and seven worlds below. Arjuna is actually seeing all the seven worlds above and below, including the Patala Loka, including the Satya Loka at the top. So he is just saying, I am seeing so many things in you, O Krishna. And I am also seeing many hands, many legs. Your form is ultimate. Can I tell you that I am actually frightened? Is what he is saying. I am trembling with fear, is what Arjuna says. Now Arjuna, a man who doesn't know fear, is trembling with fear is because one cannot fathom the true nature of God when actually shown. We take him for granted, we call him names, we do a lot of things with him. There are people who even chide him and insult him. But the true form of the God, none of us can stand together. And Arjuna, in spite of being blessed by Krishna to say, he is actually frightened.
Rupam mahatte bahuvaktra netram mahabaho bahubahu rupadam bahudaram bahudamstrakaralam drishtvalokam pravyatitastataham.
Hey Krishna, he says in the sloka, that I am seeing a form which is just beyond imagination, beyond comprehension. I am seeing so many hands, so many legs of yours. Sahasra bahu is the term he uses. So thousands of bahu, the shoulders or arms of yours I am seeing, is what he is saying. Arjuna says, hey Krishna, we saw their loka and aloka, all the worlds are trembling. I am also trembling, is what Arjuna says. Arjuna is a man of valor, epitome of valor. And here we are seeing him trembling because of the supreme vision that he is getting to see, which is just not, cannot be handled or fathomed in true sense. That is why he is in fear. And he says, when the worlds are trembling and I am trembling, we all know only one thing, that you are Mahabahu, you are our true protector, and here we are seeking your protection, and that is what he is asking. Hey Krishna, protect us, hey Mahabahu, protect us.
Arjuna vacha sanyasasya Mahabaho tatvamichami veditum tyagasya charishikesha pritakkeshi nishudana.
So this is the sloka from the 18th chapter. Mahabharata, Bhagavad Gita, as we know, has got 18 chapters, and 18th chapter is most important, as it's called the Moksha Sanyasa Yoga, in which at 66 sloka of 18th chapter, Sri Krishna says, surrender unto me. So it's all about surrendering, it's all about realizing that Sri Krishna is supreme and surrendering. In this sloka, in 18th chapter, first sloka itself, Arjuna addresses him as Mahabahu. If you find an interesting connotation, this sloka also has got another name called Rishikesa. Rishikesa is one which, as a name, we enjoyed its spirit, its meaning, and the context in the 10th episode of Namagita. So, Rishikesa, what does it mean? To recollect, one who is controlled, who is the lord of all senses. In earlier chapter, in 11th and 6th, Arjuna asks, hey Mahabahu, I am able to do penance, but I am driven in all directions. What drives us in all directions? Our senses. So whom do you address it? You address it to Rishikesa, because one who can control our senses, he is the Lord who can control our senses. So here in 18th chapter, first sloka, along with Rishikesa, he says Mahabahu, because you are the one who can command and control our senses, you please protect us so that we are always focused on you. In this chapter, 18th chapter, he is talking about, Arjuna is having questions about sannyasa and tyag, the sacrifice. Now, who else can he ask? He can ask Dhritarashtra, he can ask Bhima and all this. They may have the same doubts as Arjuna is. He may ask Vishwamitra, Bhishma and all that. They can clarify to an extent that they can reach. But here, he is talking to Sri Krishna, the Supreme Lord himself, about what is sacrifice, what is sannyas and what is sacrifice. It's because Krishna is the one who knows what sacrifice is. We are just saying in the last three episodes, he is Mahabahu, he is Sarvaloka Maheshwara, but he is also a Suhrit. He sits with the Gopas and eats their food and plays around with them as a child. He then drives chariot for Arjuna. He takes care of the horses during the 18-day Kurukshetra war. What else can a supreme being do when he has sacrificed his abode just to be with Arjuna, just to help Pandavas and Draupadi, and just because Draupadi surrendered when during Vastraharan, just to protect them? That is the supreme sacrifice, an epitome of sacrifice, where he comes and goes as an ambassador, drives the chariot and is there as friendly as he can. But we also saw in the 11th chapter how supreme he is that we can't even see him in normal life. So Arjuna, with all these three utterances of Mahabahu to Sri Krishna, clearly leads us to understand. See, at the end of the day, Arjuna is a representative of us. As much as Sri Krishna teaches us directly, he teaches us through Arjuna also. When Arjuna addresses Mahabahu to Krishna and we dwell in the meaning of Mahabahu, only then we realize how great our Sri Krishna is. There are many, many, many instances in Srimad Bhagavatam, in Vishnu Purana, anywhere you take, you will know the whole of Mahabharata, you will know a lot of things where Krishna is great. But when you relate to the terms Sarvaloka Maheshwara, Akhilandakodi Brahmandanayaka and Mahabahu, you realize the Lord who commands everything, the entire universe. We saw how the universe keeps growing and growing in the earlier episode. And he commands everything, and he is the same Mahabahu who's got the power and the command to protect us and give us shelter. The experience is very different when, along with Arjuna, we realize that the divine feet of Sri Krishna is all we need as shelter, and he as Mahabahu will protect us all the time, every time. So let us keep thinking of Sri Krishna and keep chanting his names. Namaste.
Madhava Achyuta Krishna Hare Rishikesha Keshava Govinda Vasudeva Bhagavan Janardana.